Hello students, in this lecture we are going to discuss the main topics. The first topic we will discuss development of resource, the second topic sustainable development, and under the sustainable development we will discuss Earth Summit 1992, and after the Earth Summit 1992 resource planning, and in the resource planning we will discuss the topic resource planning in India and the most important topic, that is the conservation of resource. So these are the main topics today we have to cover it in this lecture. So yesterday we have started this chapter, and under this chapter or the yesterday topic we have already discussed what is resource, what is development, and what is the relationship of the human being among the physical environment and technology and institution. And already we have discussed the classification of the resources, different types of the resources we have discussed yesterday. So firstly, to we start the today lecture with the topic development of resource. So what is the development of resource? When we are saying the word development, development means something is not happened in a positive way with the resource. And why there is a need of the development of resource? The first one, wastage of resource. You can write these point, wastage of resource, that's why there is need of the development of resource. Second point, exploitation of resource. And third point, that is overuse of resource. And here the word resource indicates natural resource. So with these three points there is need to the development of resource. And all we know that the resources are the free gifts of the nature for the mankind, and mankind is not possible without the resources. And when we are talking about the resources, our mind should divert towards the resources like soil, like water, like air, like minerals, clear, like flora and fauna, all these types of the resources. Okay, so these are the free gifts of the nature, and human being with the help of the technology is utilizing the resources at the extent level. So due to the exploitation of the resources, overusing of the resources, few problems has been occurred. Which are the main problem which are have been occurred in the recent times? So the first point, depletion of resources. Kya problem hai sabse pehle? Depletion of resources. And under the depletion of resources means the resources are going to extinct. Second one, accumulation of resources in few hands. And human society can be divided into two parts, the first one rich and second one is the poor. And the third one, exploitation of resources has led to the ecological crisis. And what kind of the ecological crisis? Like global warming, ozone layer depletion, environmental pollution and land degradation. And one important example, that is the coronavirus, under which all the mankind has suffered totally. And why this coronavirus has been occurred? Because human being not utilizing the resources properly, not utilizing the nature properly, the relationship between human and the nature, that become enemy relationship with one another. Why? Because human is not doing his duty properly with respect to the nature. So these are the main problem which have been occurred due to the not proper using of the resources. So that's why we have to need development of the resources. So for the proper utilization of the resources, one concept has been rises from the Earth Summit 1992 that held in Rio de Janeiro. And this Rio de Janeiro that lies in Brazil, it is the name of place Rio de Janeiro, and this place is in the Brazil, which is the part of the South America continent. So let's see the location of the Rio de Janeiro or Brazil over the world map. So So dear student, this is the world map, and here we are going to discuss the location of the Rio de Janeiro, that is in the South America continent, is in the Brazil country. So here firstly we have the Asia, Europe, Africa, Australia, North America, and this one is the South America. So Rio de Janeiro, that lies in the South America continent, and under the South America continent, here is the largest country of the South America, that is the Brazil, is the largest country of the South America, and the capital of the Brazil, that is the Brasilia. The capital is Brasilia, and the capital city of the Brazil, that is Rio. It is simply called as the Rio. So Rio de Janeiro, that lies in this point, that is the Rio de Janeiro. So this one is the location of the Rio de Janeiro or the Brazil, where the 1992 Earth Summit has been held. So dear student, we have discussed where the Rio de Janeiro or Brazil has been found over the Earth, over the map of the world. So this Earth Summit give birth to the main important term, that is the sustainable development. So first understand the what is the sustainable development. Sustainable development means proper use of resources without harming the environment. Oh, clear? So its definition you can write. So write, do the development without harming the nature or environment. So what is the sustainable development? Do the development without harming the environment, or we can say that sustainable development refers to the development should take place, or you can write this definition also, development should take place without damaging or harming the environment, that is called as the sustainable development. And this term has been comes from the Rio de Janeiro Earth Summit, which held in 1992. Okay, so what is the Rio de Janeiro Earth Summit 1992? And one important question under the this summit, that this Earth Summit has been called by the UNCERT, important abbreviated form hai, that is the UNCERT. So iski full form hai, UNCERT ki full form hai, United Nation Conference on Environment and Development. UNCERT ki full form, United Nation Conference on Environment and Development. So which called the Earth Summit 1992. So what is the main positive point, what is the characteristics of this Earth Summit? So which are, firstly, in June 1992, first important point, in which month this Earth Summit had held, that is in June 1992, under the 100 heads of the states mean countries, clear, state means here countries. So 100 countries have participated in the month of June 1992 under the one concept, that is the Earth Summit, and which concept has been rises, that is the sustainable development. And this conference has been called by the UNCERT, United Nation Conference on Environment and Development, very important abbreviated form hai. Uske baad 1992 mein ye conference hui, that 100 heads of the state attended this conference in Rio de Janeiro in Brazil. And this is the first international Earth Summit, very important point, this was the first Earth Summit, international summit. And under this, what are the main goals? So first one, environmental protection, social economic development at the global level. So first point, environmental protection and social economic development. And this Earth Summit was signed signed for the climatic change and biological diversity. And one important point has been comes out from this earth summit, that is the agenda 21. And agenda 21 means sustainable development in the 21st century. So this is called as agenda 21. 21 here refers for the sustainable development for the 21st century. So this is called as the agenda 21. Now comes out the agenda 21. So this earth summit held in 1992, June 1992, and who called this conference? That is the UNCED, United Nations Conference on Environment and Development, which took place at Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. And the main goal is sustainable development, and under the sustainable development, the main agenda is to discuss the environmental damage, poverty, diseases through global cooperation and common interest, and also shared objectives related to the environment from one country to another country. And this agenda 21 should be draw out by the local government, should be draw out by the local government. That is called as the agenda 21. So agenda 21 refers to agenda for the 21st century under the headings of sustainable development. So all you are now able to write about the agenda 21 and the sustainable development. Now the next topic is resource planning. So resource planning means the proper utilization of resource is called as the resource planning, and under the resource planning there should be no overuse of the resources and no wastage of resources. That is called as the resource planning, that is proper utilization of the resource. So if we are taking the example of our country, that in our country various types of the resources have been found, like in the states of the Jharkhand, in the states of Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, and Odisha, West Bengal region, Tamil Nadu region, Karnataka region. So in all these states there are different types of the coal reserves, minerals reserve, like iron ore is there, manganese is there, and aluminium bauxite is there. So these resources are found here in abundance form. So the proper utilization of resources should be there, and it is the responsibility of the government how the people are using these resources. So this is called as the resource planning. If we are again taking the example of the Rajasthan region, where the solar energy and wind energy, that is in found in abundance form, and in the cold desert, that is called as the Ladakh region, that is where is the different types of resources like nuclear power resources are there. So the proper utilization of resource is simply called as the resource planning. Now the next topic is the resource planning in India. So what are the major policies for the resource planning in India by the government? So different types of the strategies, different types of the planning have been made out by the Indian government. So let's see what is the main resource planning in the India. The first one, identification and inventory resources across the region of the country. So first one is identification of resource. Second one is planning structure endowed with appropriate technology, skill and institutional setup with the implementing resource development plans. So second main keyword is here, that is the planning structure. And the third one, that is matching of goals, matching of resource planning plans with the national development plans. So now with the example, how we can do the proper planning of the resources in our country? Firstly, we have to identify the resource. Where is the resource? The first main point to find out the resource for the resource planning, first point is identification. सबसे पहले क्या पता होना चाहिए, रिसोर्सेज कहाँ पे है. सो फर्स्टली द लोकेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज मीन आइडेंटिफिकेशन. ठीक है, लोकेशन पता चल गई. उसके बाद द सेकंड पॉइंट क्या होगा, दैट इज प्लानिंग. हाउ द रिसोर्सेज, हाउ दोज दीज रिसोर्सेज शुड बी यूज, एंड दैट रिसोर्सेज द प्रॉपर यूटिलाइजेशन इज कॉल्ड एज द रिसोर्स. एंड द थर्ड वन, द मैचिंग ऑफ द गोल्स. क्या करने हैं, गोल मैच करने हैं, मैचिंग ऑफ गोल्स. सो थ्री पॉइंट्स यू शुड हैव टू बी अंडरस्टैंड. द फर्स्ट वन इज द लोकेशन, सेकंड वन इज द प्लानिंग एंड थर्ड वन इज द गोल. सो अंडरस्टैंड हेयर द फर्स्ट वन आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज यानी लोकेशन. सो आइडेंटिफिकेशन कैसे करेंगे, हाउ वी कैन डू द आइडेंटिफिकेशन. द फर्स्ट वन सर्वेइंग, सर्वे करना पड़ेगा. कंसल्टेंसी विद द पीपल, लोगों से पूछना पड़ेगा. मैपिंग विद द हेल्प ऑफ द डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ द सॉफ्टवेयर लाइक GIS एंड GPS, हमें क्या करनी पड़ेगी, मैपिंग करनी पड़ेगी ओवर द मैप्स. एंड एस्टिमेशन एंड मेजरमेंट ऑफ रिसोर्स. तो फर्स्ट पॉइंट में क्या होगा, आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज विद द हेल्प ऑफ सर्वेइंग एंड मैपिंग. सो मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट यू कैन राइट, आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज विद द हेल्प ऑफ सर्वेइंग एंड मैपिंग. सो दिस वन इज द फर्स्ट step in the resource planning. Now come to the second step, that is the proper planning structure. And what type of proper planning structure, that involve proper use of technology, skill and institution. Proper use of technology, skill and institution. So second point kya hoga, proper planning structure with the help of technology, skill and institutional setup. And the third point here, that is matching the goals. So matching the goal kiske, resource development plans and the national development plans, dono ko kya karna hai, match karna hai. So matching the resource development plan and the national development plans. So three points, the first one identification of resource and with the help of surveying and mapping. Second point, planning structure with the help of technology, skill and institutional setup. And the third point, matching of resource development plan with national development plan. So these are the three main steps comes under the resource planning in India. This is very very important question. Question can be asked by the examiner in the form of discuss major steps under the resource planning in India or in the world. So first point, identification of resources with the help of surveying and mapping. Second one, the proper planning structure with the help of technology, skill and institutional setup. And third point, matching of resource development plan with the national development plan. So these are the three major steps under the resource planning in India. Okay, now come to the next discussion. Here different types of the resources people have, different types of the resources in the world have, but these resources are not utilizing properly. And the as we are all know, the deforestation is the major problem. Exploitation of resources is the major problem. And technological innovation, again technological innovation like different types of machineries has been developed by the people, but people are utilizing these machineries for exploiting the resources like mining is again responsible for the degradation of the land resources. So in simple word, we can say that the human being is totally responsible for the exploitation of the resources and nature, exploitation of nature, exploitation of resources. So here the one important question can be comes out, that how the resources are going to be exploited, discuss the reason. So here are two reasons, one is man-made reason, second one is the natural region. And under the natural region, we can say that the volcanoes, earthquakes, floods, that is the natural region. But these are the general. Here we should have to give emphasis over the man-made region like mining, exploitation of resources, deforestation, wastage of resources, exploitation of resources, overuse of resources. Clear? Mining, ye sare ke sare point iske under mein aayenge. Then today's last topic is the conservation of the resources. Now it is the responsibility of the human being to conserve the resources. If human being is the cause, then human being will give the solution for that problem. Again, I am here forwarding a very important point related to the coronavirus. If coronavirus is produced by the human being, understand? Coronavirus is produced by the human being. So human being become cause. Human being kya bana? Karan bana, cause bana. So who will give the solution? So solution ultimately given by human beings. So human beings is the cause and human being is the solution. So we should have to be work in very politely way, very simple way, and cooperate with one and another. Then with the help of these, using these type of the strategies, we can overcome from this problem, that is the coronavirus. So how we can do the conservation of the resources? So different types of the techniques here we have, like control on deforestation, control on overgrazing, control on mining, that proper use of resources, proper planning structure of resources should be made by the people. Then government should have to play a very crucial role to awareing the people regarding the conservation of the resources. Government, and again most important point, government should have to form the laws, and that laws should be implemented and regulated properly. It is the responsibility of the government, and again as the citizen of this country or citizen of this world, that it is our responsibility to proper utilization of resources, not harm the nature, not harm the environment. That is the main terms we have discussed under the sustainable development. So sustainable development refers to what? That is, do not harm the environment. Do the development without harming, without influencing the environment. So here one important terms has been given by, that is the Gandhiji, Mahatma Gandhiji, that is, there is enough resources for everybody needs, but not for everybody greed. Very important terms has been given by Mahatma Gandhiji. So mostly in the exams, question will be asked in the form, who said this term, yeah, whose word this, there is enough resources for everybody needs, but not for everybody greed. So this term is given by Gandhiji, and this one, different types of the points I have referred in this video here, how we can conserve the resources. So, and one most important point, human being have to remove his characteristic, that is the greedy nature and selfish nature. We should have to think for the nature, for the environment. If we want to find out the ways to protect the mankind from the coronavirus, then we should have to leave this point, that is the greedy and selfish way. We should handshake with the nature and work together with the advancement, with the development of the nature, with regard to the development of the human being. So these two important point for the development of the human beings and as well as the development of the nature. So this is the very important topic today we have discussed. Tomorrow again one important topic here, that is most important topic, why the term sustainable development comes in the news, comes in most important for the last few decades. Because the first term in 1974, the most important decade, that is in 1974, the Gandhian philosophy was once again, Gandhian philosophy, and that is presented by Schumacher, and Schumacher has wrote a book, that is Small is Beautiful, and Small is Beautiful book has been written by Schumacher in 1974, and under this book he presented the idea of Gandhi philosophy. So that book, Small is Beautiful, refers the idea of the sustainable development. And again, one most important work done by the Brundtland Commission report in 1987, and that commission report, the concept that is published by Brundtland Commission report, that is the Our Common Future. And this Brundtland Commission report 1987, that is book has written wrote a book, that is Our Common Future. And these two books, the one is Small is Beautiful, which is written by Schumacher, and Our Common Future, that comes from the Brundtland Commission 1987 report. So this to work give birth to the Earth Summit 1992, which held in the Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. So today we have discussed most important topic and these two important questions. Small is beautiful book written by whom, and our common future comes from which report in which year. So that is in 1987 our common future, and 1974 small is beautiful. So dear student, you can make the notes from these videos. So today we have discussed very important topic. Tomorrow we will discuss the most important topic, that is the land resources, and under the land resources, land utilization we will discuss, land use pattern in India, and in the land use pattern in India we will discuss the land degradation and conservation. So this is whole about the today's lecture. If you found any type of confusion and doubt, kindly send me the message in reply box, and you can see all the videos in my videos. So great day ahead. Thank you.